Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educates.tv and today I'm very excited because I am going to show you a new development board, the Sipeed M1 Dock, which features the revolutionary $10 K210 AI chip. Just like the ESP32, this chip is going to change everything, bringing hardware AI to the maker community. There is a lot to cover, so let's get started. Just a few weeks ago, while searching for new boards, I discovered the Sipeed M1 Dock board, which was featuring an unknown to me at the time processor named K210. There were no reviews for the product, but I ordered it anyway to test it. The price was very tempting. I paid less than $30 for a board with a camera and a 2.4-inch display. I will post a link to this item in the description of the video. After reading more about the K210 processor the board is using, I was blown away. This thing is extremely powerful. I couldn't wait to get my hands on it. The last time I was so excited about a board was when the ESP32 was released 2 years ago. The board arrived in a small box. Let's see what's inside. The Sipeed M1 dock board I got features the following: the Kintrite K210 processing unit, a 2.4-inch LCD display with a resolution of 320 by 240 pixels, a 2-megapixel camera, a USB-C type connector, 2 push button, an RGB LED, a micro SD card slot and a microphone. After connecting the display and the camera to the board, I managed to get this board to work after a couple of hours. The documentation is in early development stages, so it took me more time than usual to get started. Check this out, I have loaded a face detection example and as you can see the board has no problem to detect many faces at the same time with a great frame rate. Impressive for a $30 board. Let's now take a look at the heart of the board, the K210 chip. It features the following: two 64-bit RISC-V cores, each with a built-in independent FPU operating at 400 MHz, a KPU, a high-performance convolutional neural network hardware accelerator, an audio processing unit, 8 MB of RAM memory, 16 MB of flash memory, FFT hardware accelerator, 48 GPIO pins, I2C, SPI, I2S interfaces, PWM, direct memory access controller, and much more. The specifications are fantastic. Can you tell why I am so excited about this chip? Besides the fact that this board uses a very fast processor and a huge amount of RAM, this chip also offers a hardware neural network accelerator. This is huge. This is the real reason I am so excited about this chip. This hardware neural network accelerator is the reason this chip will outperform every other chip at machine vision. Forget about OpenMV, Pixie, Raspberry Pi or the ESP32. This thing is the fastest computer vision board you can get under $60. Amazing stuff. Even if you don't need the neural network accelerator, you still get an extremely powerful processor. Check this out. This board outperforms the ESP32 in every field. It has a much faster central processing unit and a massive amount of memory and, of course, AI hardware. If we compare it with the other machine vision boards I have tried, it outperforms them as well. Nothing can beat this chip in machine vision at this price range. This is the first capable AI board for makers. The first ever board to feature AI hardware was the Arduino 101 I reviewed 2 years ago. It featured the Intel Curie processor, which was using a very small hardware neural network, which was almost useless because it was very small and Intel never actually taught us how to use it. The board was abandoned by Intel some time ago. So, this, the K210, is the only chip with hardware AI acceleration available today and it is very powerful. It can do object detection at 60 frames per second at VGA resolution. Enough with the specs, let's now use it for the first time. There are many ways to program the board. We can even use our familiar Arduino IDE, but I prefer to use the OpenMV IDE, which is easier to work with. The procedure is very easy if you know what you have to do. First of all, we have to download the latest firmware version, which is 0.32 at the time of this recording. Next, we upload it to the board using the KFlash utility after selecting the board we have connected to the computer. Now we need to download the MyXPy ID and we are ready to go. You can find links to all the software I use in the description of the video below. The MyXPy ID is a cloned version of the OpenMV ID, so it feels very familiar. In order to use the board, we have to connect it to the computer, select the board we want to use, and press the connect button. Now we write MicroPython code here and execute it in the board. Let's run the first example that comes with the IDE. We press the run button and the board displays live video from the camera to the LCD display and the IDE at the same time. Cool. Let's now load a more advanced example. Let's load the face recognition example I showed you in the beginning. The example consists of two parts, the Python code which can be found in the GitHub page of the creators of the board, and the face detection model we need to use along with the Python script. In order to be able to use the model, we need to burn it in the flash memory of the chip. We use the kflash utility once more, and it will automatically burn the model at the correct location to the flash memory of the chip. Now, if we run the Python script, the face detection example works great. With just 23 lines of code, we detect faces. Amazing! If I connect a power meter to the board while the script is running without the display, we can see that it needs around 200 milliamps of current. Amazing stuff! We can run AI algorithms on a board that requires just 1 watt of power to operate. Let's now load a more impressive example. I have loaded a pre-trained model, the mobile net, which is pre-trained to recognize 1000 objects. Check this out, it can detect many everyday objects and many animals with ease. The accuracy is pretty good considering we are running this script on a $30 board. This is truly impressive and revolutionary. You can modify this model if you wish and make it recognize any object you want. I will try this in the future. It sounds so cool. This board is not perfect though. It lacks analog inputs, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. So, Sipeed has just created MyXDuino, an Arduino-like board with a K210 chip for AI and with an ASP32 for everything else. I can't wait to get my hands on this board as well. The artificial intelligence revolution has started and it is going to change everything in a few years. This is just the beginning. Boards like this would have been science fiction even 5 years ago. Our projects can now use the power of artificial intelligence. The pace at which AI is advancing is extremely fast, so learning the basics of AI is a very useful skill to have. I can't wait to learn how to develop my own AI models and use them with this board. I would love to know your opinion about this board. What kind of applications do you think they will benefit from a board like this one? Thanks for your ideas and for watching the video. I'll see you next week!